Today is Captain Dog's birthday.
Happy birthday, Captain Dog!
Thank you, everyone.
Daddy, you look sad.
Oh, it's nothing, son. Just seeing this here boat reminded me how much I miss the sea.
Captain Dog loves the sea.
Why not open your birthday present? It's a boat trip.
A boat trip? That's just what I wanted. Let's go! There's nothing better than sailing a boat. You could go anywhere you want in a sailing boat. We could head for the tropics or have an Arctic adventure. We might even see a whale.
It's just a day trip, dear.
This is the canal.
Now, where's the sailing boat?
We're going on this canal boat.
I see. We use the canal boat to get to the sailing boat.
No, dear. We're going on this boat for your birthday, and we're sailing it down the canal.
But on a canal, you can only go this way and that way.
It'll be fun.
Come on, Dad. It is a boat.
Yes, Danny, you're right. A boat on the water.
All aboard.
Oh, I wanted to say that.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go on, then.
All aboard! Raise the sail! Oh, where is the sail?
Canal boats do not have sails.
You just push this button to make the boat go.
Ah, thank you, Mummy Dog. And we're away.
Mrs. Duck is going faster than our boat.
Want a race, do you, Mrs. Duck? Full steam ahead! Can't this thing go any faster?
No, this is the top speed.
Oh.
Anyway, you want to slow down. We're coming to a mountain!
Ah!
Look out! There's a mountain in front!
We're gonna crash straight into it!
No, we're going into the tunnel.
There is a tunnel through the mountain.
It's all gone dark. And our voices sound funny.
We sailed straight through the middle of a mountain. Ha ha! This canal boat is actually quite fun.
Look, here comes another mountain.
And that means another tunnel.
Not this time.
Oh, there's no tunnel.
So what do we do?
We're going uphill.
There's no way in the world a boat can go uphill.
There is, and it's called a lock. Watch, I'll show you.
Mummy Dog is opening the gates to the lock.
Take her in, Captain. Just wait there while I close these lock gates. Now I'm letting in the water from the top.
We're going up.
The rising water is lifting the canal boat up.
Now I opened these gates. Take her out, Captain.
Full steam ahead! Whoa! Where's the ground gone?
We're in the sky!
We're sailing over a bridge.
Yes, this bridge means we can sail high above the valley below.
Ha-ha! Sailing across the sky. What could be a better adventure?
Sailing across the sky in a boat so high. Floating on the water, sailing across the sky.
Have you had a fun time, Daddy?
I should say so. I've sailed through mountains, over hills, and across the sky. This is my best birthday ever.
Captain Dog loves canal boats. Everyone loves canal boats. Peppa and her family are visiting Madame Gazelle.
Hello, Madame Gazelle.
Hello, everyone. Come in, come in.
Whoa! Whoa! Your hallway is a big slide, Madame Gazelle.
Is it meant to be like that?
No, The house is just old.
Everything here is a little bit wonky-donky.
Aho! Everything is leaning now, but it wasn't always this way.
When did your house start leaning, Madam Gazelle?
Oh, I don't know. It's been so long. And now I have cracks everywhere, too.
I think your house might need fixing.
Can't I just paper over the cracks and paint it? That is what my builder told me to do.
What does the outside wall look like? Ah, what's this?
Oh, that is my little Christmas tree.
That's not little. That's big.
It was from Christmas a long time ago. It was a little baby tree with a fairy on top. After Christmas, I could not bear to throw it away, so I planted it in the garden.
Your baby tree has grown so much, it's pushing your house over.
That's why your house is all wonky-donky.
Oh, dear. What can we do about it?
I'll call Mr. Bull.
Hello, Mr. Bull.
We have a big tree that needs looking at.
I'll be right there. So, where's this tree then?
Here it is.
That's a mighty fine tree you have there, Madam Gazelle. Strong roots.
Yes, but it's pushing the house over.
Oh, yes. Let's chop it down.
Oh, dear, my poor tree.
Stop! I saw something move in the tree. It was a little animal.
In that case, I must take a look.
Before Mr. Bull chops the tree down, he must check that no animals are living in it.
Ah!
Mr. Bull has found a bird's nest.
Look at that! Little birdies nesting in your tree, Madam Gazelle.
Please, can I see the birdies?
Okay, Peppa. We can watch from the windows.
Ooh, lovely birdies.
I think there's something else higher up the tree. Look what's here!
Buzzy bees!
Let's see what else there is. I say, look at this!
It's an owl!
Oh, I think I see something else. Onward and upward. Aha! You've got bats, Madam Gazelle!
Ah, my friends the bats. They remind me of the old country.
And what's this?
Ah, my Christmas decorations!
And a fairy!
That is the fairy I put on the little tree all those years ago.
It's a magnificent tree. A wonderful home to so many little animals.
Yes, this tree should not be chopped down.
Hooray!
But wait, if the tree stays, what will happen to my house?
Well, eventually it will fall over.
But I need a house to live in.
Oh.
I've got an idea. We'll put your house in the tree. Mr. Bull, the crane, please.
Right you are!
It's a tree house!
Yes, it is wonderful. I have always wanted to live in a tree house. Thank you, everyone.
Hooray!
Madame Gazelle loves tree houses. Everyone loves tree houses.
Once upon a time.
Peppa and George are looking at storybooks.
Look, George. This is an exciting adventure. There are fairies and three bears who can't stop eating porridge. And a naughty wolf who's looking for an old lady to eat.
Oh.
Don't worry, George. It's always a happy ending. I wish we lived in a fairy story.
Peppa, George, it's time to go.
Are we going on an adventure?
Yes, we're going to Granny and Grandpa Pig's house for lunch.
That's not an adventure.
There'll be potatoes.
Can we bring our picture books to read in the car?
We're not going in the car, Peppa. We're walking there instead.
Walking? All the way to Granny and Grandpa's house?
Yes, there's a shortcut through the park.
Will there be dragons and fairies in the park?
Not that I know of.
But it will be a nice walk.
But there won't be any magic.
Maybe. If we look hard enough,
we might see some.
Peppa and George have arrived at the park.
It doesn't feel like a magic place.
Oh, I don't know. It feels a bit magic to me.
Yes, this is like the path in Little Red Riding Hood.
I wouldn't be surprised if we bumped into the big bad wolf.
Hello there.
It is Mr. Wolf.
Hello, Mr. Wolf. How are you?
Very well, thank you. Just a little bit hungry. I'm trying to decide where to go for lunch.
I'm going to my granny's house for lunch.
Are you really?
Yes.
Is it far?
Not far. This is the shortcut. We'll be there soon.
Very good. Oh, well, catch you later.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye. That was just like Little Red Riding Hood. Meeting Mr. Wolf in the middle of the woods when I'm going to Granny's house.
Which way now, Daddy Pig?
I'm not sure.
There's a little house over there. Let's ask them the way.
Hello?
Is there anybody home? I wonder who lives here in the middle of the woods.
There are three chairs.
And three bowls of porridge.
Hello, Peppa.
Here are Belinda Bear and Mummy and Daddy Bear.
Hello there.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Bear. Sorry to trouble you.
The door was open, so we came inside.
It's quite all right. It's lovely to see you.
Are you going to stay for lunch, Peppa? It's porridge. It's not too hot or too cold,
but just right.
We're actually on our way to have lunch at Granny and Grandpa Pig's house.
Could you point us in the right direction, please?
That path there will take you to Granny Pig's house.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Wow. That was just like Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Yes, with a little house and three chairs.
And three bowls of porridge.
We are in a fairy tale.
Peppa has arrived at Granny and Grandpa Pig's house.
Granny Pig, we're here.
Hello.
Oh.
Here is Mr. Wolf.
Mr. Wolf, why are you here?
I'm just round for something to eat. Your granny has made a lovely lunch.
Mm-mm. Yes, I've made a lovely lunch and it's ready now. Come inside.
Hello, Peppa. Hello.
Wendy Wolf has come for lunch too.
Lunch is served.
Hooray!
Potatoes!
Ho ho! You can never have too many potatoes.
Wendy, I've had an adventure in the fairy tale woods.
Ooh, what's the fairy tale woods?
It's where you live inside a fairy story.
Peppa loves fairy stories. Everyone loves fairy stories. Peppa, George and Susie are playing in the garden with their favourite toys. George has Mr. Dinosaur. Susie has Penguin. And Peppa has Teddy.
Teddy, what game shall we play?
Squeak, squeak!
You want to roll down the hill? Okay! Let's jump in muddy puddles! What's that, Teddy? You want to jump in muddy puddles too? Okay! Splash, splash, splash. Whoops!
Peppa has slipped and fallen on Teddy.
Sorry, I sat on you, Teddy.
Are you all having fun?
Yes!
Yes, Mummy Pig!
Oh, Teddy, you look a bit under the weather.
What do you mean?
Teddy is a bit muddy.
Oh!
I took Penguin to the doll hospital and now he's as good as new.
What's a doll hospital?
It's where dolls go to get better. They get washed, filled up with stuffing, and even get new voices.
You are my best friend,
Susie.
I love you a lot.
Susie,
Ooh! Mummy, can we take Teddy to the doll hospital, please?
What a good idea!
This is the doll hospital.
Hello, Miss Rabbit.
Hello, Peppa. Welcome to the doll hospital, where we turn dolls like this into dolls like this.
Ooh!
Have you got a sick dolly?
Yes.
What is it? A mouse or a dog?
It's a bear.
Well, we have got our work cut out, haven't we? Ah! And a dinosaur. Are you booking them both in?
Yes, please.
OK. So tell me, little bear, what have you been doing to get so poorly?
Teddy has been rolling down hills, jumping in muddy puddles and being sat on.
It's no wonder you're not looking your best. There'll be no more rolling down hills, jumping in muddy puddles or being sat on once I've finished with you.
But Teddy likes doing those things.
You do seem a bit floppy. Nothing some extra stuffing won't fix.
What do you mean?
Look, this elephant is a bit sad, but he just needs more stuffing.
Teddy likes being floppy, thank you, Miss Rabbit.
Would Mr. Dinosaur like some extra stuff? OK. Would Teddy like a new outfit? Here we have a smart sailor's uniform.
But Teddy is a girl.
Girls can be sailors too, Peppa.
Yes, but Teddy doesn't want to be a sailor.
How about a pilot?
No.
Deep sea diver?
No.
What about a princess?
I think Teddy is happy not to have any clothes, thank you, Miss Rabbit.
What about Mr. Dinosaur?
No.
Fair enough. Would Teddy like new eyes? You know what they say, the eyes are the windows to the soul.
What's a soul?
It's a bit complicated. Just look at these eyes. We've got green eyes, blue eyes, or even these googly eyes.
The soul thingy might look a bit wrong with those eyes on. Teddy's eyes don't need changing, thank you, Miss Rabbit.
What about Mr. Dinosaur? Does he want some new eyes?
No.
Fine. One thing I can offer you, Teddy, is a new voice. The voices come in little plastic boxes which go inside the doll.
Hello, I love you.
That isn't how Teddy talks.
I'm so happy. I want to play.
That's not Teddy.
You are my best friend.
But that's Penguin's voice.
You are my best friend.
Susie.
Mr. Dinosaur, do you want a new voice? Silly question, really. There is one last thing I can do for you, Teddy. That's give you a wash.
No, Teddy doesn't need a wash.
OK, I'm finished. And it's good news. There's nothing wrong with Teddy or Mr. Dinosaur.
That's wonderful.
Would you like to pay by cash or credit card?
Oh.
Teddy, I love you just the way you are, and I always will.